this evening.
We got a great broadcast for you tonight, everybody. It's certainly coming on the heels of Mr. McMahon's major announcement last night on Raw that shocked everybody, I'll tell you that.
Whoa, no. That's not the major announcement. Vinnie Mac's going to have the major announcement tonight. It's the master plan he's going to reveal tonight, JR.
Boy, this is one weird son of a gun right here, this Gangrel. Not to say he's not a great athlete, but he is a very strange man. And for some reason, you got to think that Edge and Gangrel's paths have crossed before coming to the WWF. Look, 3 weeks ago, Edge, more than an interested observer of Gangrel. Look, a couple of weeks ago.
Well, they definitely have issues, JR. Edge and Gangrel, I mean, this rivalry's heated up. Matter of fact, last night on a special edition of Saturday Night Raw is War, Gangrel and Edge went at it one more time. Had to be restrained by WWF officials. I say let the two bad boys go.
A couple of weeks ago, it was Edge getting in Gangrel's business, and then last night, it was Gangrel assaulting Edge. And we still don't know the reasons behind why these two men have such animosity. Well, that is not your daddy's favorite wrestler right there. That's a strange man.
It's the 90s, JR. Did you see that movie Blade with Wesley Snipes? That thing is awesome. Gangrel reminds me of one of those guys.
Well, I'll tell you what, Shane, last night on Raw, I was shocked. What extraordinary remarks made by your daddy, calling The Undertaker and Kane for politically correct wussies. And then the rampage began with The Undertaker and Kane, who, by the way, will be in tag team action here tonight for the first time. Oh, good move. But I thought that was your dad's major announcement, his master plan. I thought that was the plan, and it unfolded last night.
Well, as did I. I thought it was the master plan also. But riding back in the car, man, nice shot. Riding back in the car with Vinnie Mac last night, he just kept laughing and laughing and laughing. I go, Pop, what are you chuckling about? He goes, wait till tomorrow night on Sunday Night Heat. I get to reveal the master plan. I go, last night wasn't the master plan? He goes, no, tonight is it. Tonight I'm going to unleash the master plan on the world today. And oh, my Pop, it's going to be a doozy.
And we're going to hear it right here tonight, apparently. Look out here. Double suplex. And Togo drill right on his head.
Gangrel's impressive.
Very impressive young athlete is Gangrel. And again, we don't know the history, the story behind Gangrel and Edge, but there's something there. No doubt there's something there that maybe we don't want to know.
Riding in the car this morning with Vinnie Mac. What Vince has done now is he's been giggling and laughing so hard to himself, he went into a room all by himself. He's sequestered, and he just keeps chuckling and chuckling and chuckling. I can't wait for him to come out and let us know what the master plan is.
Well, I know your dad was unhappy that The Undertaker didn't use Kane. Oh, man, what a suplex at SummerSlam to help defeat Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Well, it wasn't so much unhappy, JR. Vince and myself and everyone else was just shocked. I mean, how stupid could The Undertaker be? Vince McMahon basically gave him the title. All he had to do was 1, 2, 3, have Kane come down.
Oh, look
and
out!
It was,
oh, man. Hello!
And do a move like that. It was over. It was inevitable.
Gangrel, what a high-impact move. And his ring attire may not be spotless, but his ring loss record is. Gangrel, a winner.
Anyway, Joe, it was inevitable that The Undertaker would have taken the World Wrestling Federation Championship off of Stone Cold.
Watch Stone Cold's head.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Love that move.
So the major announcement from Mr. McMahon is forthcoming. Austin has been summoned here by the owner of this company.
He's been ordered here. Ordered.
Well, folks, everybody knows the rivalry between Jacqueline and Sable hit the breaking point literally 3 weeks ago in an arm wrestling contest when Jacqueline's prize bikini contest trophy was destroyed in the heat of battle. Oh. Well, earlier today, Jacqueline's main man, Mark Merrill, provided us with this home video.
All right, now promise you won't look. I got the best surprise for you, my little brown sugar, my main. Don't look.
Okay,
let me check.
Henry, come on.
Okay. Well, first of all, I want to say you look absolutely marvelous in this evening gown. Nobody looks like you. And let me just tell, nobody looks like you without this evening gown. That stinking sable never looked like this. But forget all that right now. Okay, I got the biggest surprise for you. Hold on. Okay, you ready?
Uh-huh.
You can look. Yes! Your very own trophy, because that stupid sable broke your last one.
What's this? You did all this for me?
I did it all for you. I took a little bit from all our winnings off the top.
How much?
I don't want to say how much, but just let's say we've made some money with all these wins. But forget that. This is your very own trophy. WWF Bikini Champion, because you have got it going on, girl.
Thank you, baby.
Oh, man.
Sable, you skank. Take a good look at this, you swine.
Then take a good look at like this, because you'll never look like this girl. Come here, sweetie. I love you.
Oh, isn't that sweet? L-O-V-E love, Meryl and Jacqueline. Well, tonight on Sunday Night Heat, the European title is up for grabs. D'Lo Brown takes on the Big Valboski.
And the brothers to the dark side, The Undertaker and Kane, together for the first time in tag action, this time against Animal and Draws.
And the happiest man in the World Wrestling Federation, yeah, Vinnie Mac, Mr. McMahon, reveals the master plan tonight.
And as we said, the Rattlesnake is here. Austin has been summoned. He is not in a good mood. Look out, folks.
Yeah, JR, we are back. Sunday Night Heat is in full effect right here in the USA Network.
Big Tough Texan Bradshaw on his way to the ring. Folks, by the way, hope you'll join us for Raw next Saturday at 7, 6 Central here on the USA Network. We're preempted tomorrow night due to the coverage of the U.S. Tennis Open. We'll be on the air next Saturday, 7, 6 Central. And you got to wonder if Bradshaw would be willing to sign a one-on-one matchup with Vader next Saturday night, because these two guys who started out as partners last Sunday at Madison Square Garden do not, I repeat, do not get along. Bradshaw's right hand cost the team a match, and then last night, Vader and Val one-on-one. Bradshaw wanted some more of Vader, but no. Here came the Brothers of Destruction, The Undertaker and Kane. Now, Vader took a double choke slam. We'll show you that later. Val got to dominate it as well.
The world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock.
And Bradshaw, maybe the smartest guy in the group, he slid out the back door and got the heck out of Dodge.
Kenny Shamrock, OJR last night on that special edition of Saturday Night's Raw. Blackman got it. His knee is injured. Scorpio, as you said, Vader, Val, Tiger, Ali, Singh, Baboon, Meryl, and here's my favorite one. Man, the Brothers Grimm took out The Rock.
It was quite the hit list last night, perpetrated by Kane and The Undertaker. All thanks to our beloved owner of the World Wrestling Federation, Mr. McMahon, for his...
He had nothing to do with that.
...for his inspirational advice. You don't call The Undertaker and Kane, Shane, wussies, to put it correctly, I guess.
PC-wise. Oh!
Bradshaw and Shamrock. You don't call two men like that those kind of names and not expect some damage to be done.
Nice suplex by Shamrock.
Fisherman suplex by Ken Shamrock on the Big Texan. This should be a hard-hitting matchup here. Certainly Steve Blackman suffered a serious knee injury from what we can understand and have been informed. And Blackman will be required to have knee surgery thanks to The Undertaker and Kane's assault last night on Raw.
Nice move by Bradshaw. Using that full 6'7" frame to launch Shamrock halfway across the ring.
Bradshaw went all the way to the finals of the Brawl for All and met the same fate that three other of his comrades did. He got knocked out by Bart Gunn, which is certainly no embarrassment.
Oh!
Got to be impressed with the way Bradshaw is using his size and strength advantage to manhandle Shamrock here.
That was throwing Shamrock's game off a little bit. Ken's got to stay inside. He's got to get close. Ooh, nice slam. He's got to work on those joints. I don't care how big you are. Shamrock gets a hold of your ankle, you're tapping out.
Still to come tonight, the Road Dog of the New Age Outlaws takes on Dennis Knight of Southern Justice. And remember that huge tag team matchup. The Undertaker and Kane together for the first time officially in tag team action against the LOD's Animal and Draws.
Shamrock going up. Oh, he's caught by Bradshaw. Oh, yeah.
That could be it right there.
Almost. Almost.
Shamrock had to expend a lot of energy to get out of that one. Well, wait a minute. You knew it could happen at any time. Bradshaw wanted some of Vader last night in Vader's match with Val, and now Vader is returning the favor in a thunderous clothesline from the left side, knocks down the big 300-pound Texan.
Vader, Bradshaw in the retaliation. Check out Shamrock on the bottom. Oh, hold on, clothesline. Yeah.
Vader and Bradshaw are like two bulls locking horns, and Shamrock's not going to like this. Face manhood here between Bradshaw and Vader.
Oh, nice shot.
And nobody's rushing to the ringside to break these two men up.
I wouldn't want to get involved in that. No, thank you.
And Shamrock may step at any moment. They're the officials now. You threaten to fine these guys or suspend them, and they'll calm down a little bit.
The winner of this match is all of a disqualification, Bradshaw.
Bradshaw! How can Bradshaw win? Jerry, how can Bradshaw win?
Well, it's a judgment call by the official.
I agree with Shamrock. I'd be ripping.
Shamrock may have just got robbed, but he just lost to Bradshaw.
Is awaiting the tag team champions of the world.
Oh, you didn't know?
You didn't know, Jay?
Where are you? Hell, somebody! Southern Justice.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, D-Generation X proudly brings to you one half of its World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions of the World, the Road Dogg, Jesse James!
Well, Billy's not wrestling, so you don't know what to say.
Accompanied to the ringside area, he is a D-Generation X representative, the Bad Billy Gunn!
Oh yeah, and by the way, we got two words for you!
Yeah! Hey, JR! Having fun with this?
Well, yeah, I kind of like this matchup, actually.
Oh man, Road Dogg cracks me up.
So it's going to be one-on-one here. The Road Dogg and Big Dennis Knight. Knight representing Southern Justice, and Mark Canterbury will remain at ringside, as will Billy Gunn. The Outlaw successful in retaining the tag titles last evening on Raw against The Rock and Mark Henry. Even though the Outlaws were disqualified thanks to China's interference. Could you believe, Shane? Last night on Raw, China taking down Mark Henry. She was a...
Inside his face. China just took it to town.
That's just part of the 2 hours of carnage that was perpetrated by The Undertaker and Kane. Man, a long list of casualties at the hands of the Big Red Machine and the Phenom last night on Raw. And remember, Stone Cold Steve Austin has been summoned here by the owner of this company, Mr. McMahon.
See that?
Was here before most of us got here today. And we understand your daddy is here as well. And I cannot wait to hear what the master plan is. And we're going to find out that tonight.
It's going to be awesome. Anything my dad does is great. You know that, JR.
He's a dandy, all right.
He's a dandy.
You bet.
Oh yeah.
Big time right here. Look at the hit. Look at the size of Mark Canterbury. He's got to be around 315 pounds. And his right hand looks like a big old canned ham.
Well, the total carnage that happened last night on Raw Saturday night was awesome. Kane and Undertaker went through pretty much everyone on the roster.
Pillow.
Next Saturday night, another special, Raw is War. Raw Saturday night happens again, 7, 6 Central, right here on the USA Network.
And look at the Road Dogg fight back on his bigger adversary here, but there's the counter.
Oh, yeah, nice move.
Canterbury from behind with a distraction and then the big double sledge by Dennis Knight. We're going to show you some of that carnage from last night's Raw right here. Oh, well, there's Double J. Double J, who's got a war going with X-Pac. Look at the new haircut of Double J from SummerSlam.
There's X-Pac.
There's X-Pac. Double J calls X-Pac the European title last night on Raw.
It's even up here, 3-on-3. X-Pac in there. Double J, Road Dogg, Dennis Knight, Mr. A, double cookie letter. Oh, yeah, X-Pac. Double J going at it fast and furious. Throw those hands. Bam, 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 bam.
Well, this thing has broken down into nothing but a street fight. The Outlaws and X-Pac, Southern Justice and Double J. Man, there are some bad blood boiling here on Sunday Night Heat.
This is great. This is absolutely fabulous. Get it on. Oh, come on, referees. Get out of there. Let them go. Let them fight. Let them fight.
Pretty good Sunday night carnage here. And last night, the carnage was rampant at the hands of The Undertaker and Kane thanks to these words. Mr. McMahon has devised some sort of master plan.
You think about SummerSlam. The Undertaker dominated Austin. The Undertaker had the ability. He had the desire. My God, The Undertaker had an insurance policy. What did he do with that insurance policy? He sent Kane back to the locker room. Undertaker, you're a damned fool. You two guys should strike terror in the hearts of every WWF superstar. But instead, Undertaker and Kane have been reduced to nothing more than two putrid put.
What in the hell is he saying? And business is picking up here early.
September 27th, I will guarantee you, Stone Cold Steve Austin will no longer be the WWF champion.
Yeah, the master plan continues to unfold here. There you see massive destruction coming up next. size of the arm on Kane.
Oh, got his arm.
Oklahoma barbecue.
What the hell is that?
That's hot.
What a rush.
Well, this match is not going to be for the weak at heart. And you can look in Draws' eyes, in an animal's eyes, and see if their heart is where it should be. And yes, it is.
And their opponents had a combined weight of 577 pounds. Darren Drozdov, an animal.
Well, JR, it looks like Animal has finally smartened up. Darren Drozdov, could this be the new LOD 2000?
Well, I guarantee you one thing, it seems to me your dad did a good job of provoking The Undertaker and Kane last night.
Oh, absolutely. That's the master plan. I believe that's the master plan. I'm pumped up. Taker and Kane, unbelievable wrecking machine here in the World Wrestling Federation. I should say, JR, it's part of the master plan. And we're going to find out tonight here on Sunday Night Heat from Vinnie Mac himself.
I can't wait for that announcement. And we have who? Our producer's telling us that we have Hawk on the telephone. We'll patch him through. Hawk, what's on your mind here?
Well, I'm JR. Let's see. Hello, I have a little problem I need to take care of and address, and I'm back in Chicago, and I'm checking myself in for rehab to take care of it tomorrow.
Well, best of luck to you, Hawk. And
Thank you, guys.
Keep fighting the fight.
No, I will.
Well, JR, I guess that power bomb that Hawk took courtesy of Giant Silva from the Oddities really woke Hawk up.
Yeah, that was last night on Raw Saturday night. And don't forget, folks, a program reminder. Raw again on Saturday night, this Saturday at 7, 6 Central. And Kane couldn't connect on the elbow to Draws. Man, this is a real war here. And Draws, a young rookie with the experienced animal of LOD. Draws, great young athlete, Shane, but...
Three-pointer! Oh, took him off his feet! Draws took Kane off his feet!
But Kane sets right back up.
Draws is tough. Draws is still in there. You see that left, not bandage. Ooh, nice shot. Draws is in there with a torn bicep. He's playing hurt.
And now you have the Phenom and Animal of Legion of Doom.
There goes Animal.
Big foot right to the face by the 7-foot man that came within an eyelash of becoming, again, the WWF champion. And you gotta wonder who's the new number one contender here. Certainly a case can be made for The Undertaker or Kane, for that matter. And tonight, Mr. McMahon is here. Vince McMahon will reveal his master plan tonight. There's a lateral press.
Almost.
Near fall by Animal.
And don't forget, Stone Cold's in the back. He was here since the get-go, earlier than anybody, because, JR, he was summoned. He was told by Mr. McMahon to be here for this special announcement of Mr. McMahon's master plan.
Oh, what a shot. Shot in the back of the head. And the Undertaker going downstairs right on the knee. And that was a vile chop block by the 7-foot, 325-pound Undertaker. And now the Undertaker looks like he and Kane did the Steve Blackman's knee last night on Raw, working on the knee of Animal.
Oh, man, that's definitely a position you don't want to be in. Undertaker wrenching back in that submission hole. Yeah, what's up, Pop? Raise the roof, JR, raise the roof.
Well, we got a bell sounding. I don't know. Draws is trying to get the Undertaker off of Animal's leg, but I think the damage may have been done. And Draws may be about to go for a ride here.
Going up, man. Oh, yeah.
More carnage. And look, Mr. McMahon enjoys this.
Well, doesn't everybody? I'm enjoying this, aren't you, JR?
Well, somebody's going to get hurt here. I mean, these guys have got families to feed. Draws with a torn bicep. But look at the knee. It's been wrenched and torn and ripped by the Undertaker, a Road Warrior Animal.
Well, yeah, I guess Vince's commentary. Man, Mr. McMahon, we have to give him his props. He's so inspirational. He's motivational. He's my dad. And JR, he's made me the man I am today.
That's what I'm afraid of. And look at the Undertaker and Kane. I don't think that their carnage has ended here tonight, because Mr. McMahon's master plan will be revealed to the world right here tonight on Sunday Night Heat. And yes, that man, the Rattlesnake, the WWF champion, has got a bullseye on that big old chest.
Oh, Austin's gonna love the master plan. Everyone's awaiting it. But we're also awaiting Val Venus takes on D'Lo Brown for the European Championship tonight on Heat. Welcome back, everyone, to Sunday Night Heat. Taka Michinoku in the ring awaiting his opponent, Edge.
And his opponent from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 240 pounds, Edge.
Well, this young man coming through the crowd creates excitement and pandemonium each and every time we see him. Edge has one of the most desirable jobs in the WWF last Sunday at SummerSlam when Edge was the mystery partner for the lovely Sable. And look at her eyes.
Sable, very interesting choice. She chose Edge to help her combat Marvelous Mark Merrill and Jacqueline.
And they did it successfully. It's Sable and Edge, and now Edge giving chase to Taka Michinoku.
Ding, ding, ding. It has started. Nice move, Edge.
Taka elevated there by the larger Edge. Taka's got to use quickness and speed here to counteract this flurry, this furious young athlete, Edge. I'm sure the fans are wondering where Sable is this week. Sable is in California on the set of Pac Blue. And she'll be on an upcoming episode of Pac Blue. We'll let you know when that's going to be airing.
Very interesting role, I understand, Sable's playing. More on that in the weeks to come. Oh, yeah! Nice DDT!
They call it a tornado DDT, and Taka nailed it very, very well. Actually, Taka has a lot of things going for him here. He's much quicker than Edge, one would assume. But when you get stationary... Nice move by Edge, showing some great athleticism, but look at this DDT here. With the resiliency of Edge.
Taka went for it one too many times.
Edge not wasting any time here.
Yes!
What a high impact move that was.
Yes!
Some sort of reverse slam as Yamaguchi-san looks on in Taka Michinoku's behalf.
It, Edge. Get that adrenaline rush. Pump it.
Yeah. Flapjack.
Nice.
Boy, what a flapjack by Edge. And well, he doesn't know that he's not the high flyer that Taka is. Look at this.
Going up to.
Nobody there.
Taka playing a little possum there, JR.
Taka surviving.
Oh.
Missile drop kick. Found its mark. And now it may be time for the Michinoku driver.
If Taka hits this, it's over. Oh, downward spiral! Downward spiral! Yeah!
I keep looking over my shoulder for Gangrel because Edge and Gangrel got it on last night on Raw. We saw Gangrel here earlier today. And again, there's something going on between these two newcomers, Gangrel and Edge. We just don't know quite what it is.
Let's check this move out. Taka Michinoku going up and then bam! Good night!
The reversal of the Michinoku driver into the downward spiral. Great move by Edge. Oh my God, will you look at this? Look at the rampway.
Oh no. Oh, come on.
The Undertaker and Kane.
Uncle Jerry, Uncle Pat.
Patterson and Briscoe. The trusted loyal.
What are they? This is ridiculous. JR, get in there. Get in there. Help Briscoe and help Patterson.
You're talking the wrong cowboy.
Come on, get in there.
The Undertaker and Kane have taken Patterson and Briscoe hostage.
McMahon,
yes?
You've got 10 seconds to get out here or I'm going to dismantle both of your top stooges.
Want the Edge?
No.
They want that master plan now.
Eight, seven.
Where's Mr. McMahon? Mr. McMahon is not going to come out here and save Briscoe and Patterson.
Do you blame him?
Patterson and Briscoe are being sacrificed.
Oh, no!
What a
but JR, you notice, my pops, the genius he is, did not reveal the master plan until he wants to reveal the master plan.
And you gotta wonder what Stone Cold Steve Austin is thinking about this whole situation. Austin has been summoned here. Everybody wants to know what is the master plan, and we're gonna find it out tonight. Well, Briscoe and Patterson, oh my, are in a bad, bad way.
Well, let's check it out. Coming up next right here on Sunday Night Heat, yeah, the champion of Europe, D'Lo Brown, takes on the big Val Booski.
Next. We are back here on Sunday Night Heat. There's the Rattlesnake just outside the arena. Yeah. He is here. Not happy.
Yeah. Oh, he's a threat. The cameraman could have dropped that camera. That's expensive.
What about the cameraman?
The big foul, Booski.
Stone Cold Steve Austin is not happy that he was summoned to be here by the owner of this company as we still await Mr. McMahon's announcement.
The master plan. The master plan is coming up. It will be unveiled right here. Sunday Night Heat.
Well, hello to all of our fans out in California, the WWF in San Jose, a week from tomorrow, Monday, September the 14th, for Live Raw in the San Jose Arena, and then the next day in Sacramento. Raw is more at the Arco Arena in Sacramento on Tuesday, September the 15th. Tickets are going very, very rapidly for both those events. Of course, Raw coming soon to the world-famous Joe Louis Arena on Monday, September 28th, and in East Lansing, Michigan, on Tuesday, September 29th.
Hello, ladies. Make no bones about it. All of you ladies will be in Sunday Night Heat. Once you get a taste of the big Val Booski.
That kills me. Get that head shaking, JR. Here he comes.
D'Lo's got a little attitude, no doubt about it.
Let me see that head shake. Oh, yeah, he's feeling that flow. Feel that, D'Lo Brown.
Of the ring, originally from Chicago, Illinois, now residing in Warsaw.
Warsaw, Poland. Oh, my God. Val Venus is not going to waste any time in seizing the moment here. This match is for the European title. These two men met at SummerSlam. Oh, man. And Val got too carried away, got himself disqualified.
Man.
This is the third European title defense for D'Lo in a seven-day period.
Well, JR, I guess that would make the champion of Europe, D'Lo Brown, the fightingest European champion of all time.
Yeah, and from Warsaw, Poland this week, and that's a DDT.
Oh,
D'Lo Brown in trouble. Title on the line. Near fall.
Val Venus is fired up. He wants the European gold around his own waist.
Folks, we've got a capacity crowd here with us this week, and there's nothing like seeing the WWF live as the pace quickens here. And this Friday, tickets go on sale in Charlotte, North Carolina for the Powerbomb. And D'Lo, well, there's Dustin Runnels.
JR, who is he? He's coming back. Who is he?
I think that is Dustin's new spiritual force.
Advisor? Who knows? Dustin's just messed up. Taking the action to the outside. Yeah, D'Lo, take it to Val.
We were talking about tickets going on sale. This Saturday, tickets go on sale for live WWF events. Watch this. In Green Bay, in Rockford, in Tampa, Buffalo, Vancouver, and Spokane. That's tickets on sale this Saturday in all those great locations for live WWF extravaganza.
Big right hand by Val.
Val needs to get D'Lo back in the ring. You're not going to win the European title outside. You're not going to win on a countout or a disqualification.
And JR, getting back to D'Lo's chest protector. Does he actually need to wear that thing still?
I think it's bogus. The King, nice. The King tried to convince me of that last night on Raw Saturday night that D'Lo's pectoral muscles were still damaged. I ain't buying it. It's a whip. That simple. It's a shortcut for the European champion.
Well, he does have a medical excuse to wear that chest protector.
Oval's building momentum here. Well, D'Lo Brown, I'm anxious to see what kind of reception he gets in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Big weekend on September the 20th in Oklahoma City's Myriad at 2 o'clock on the 20th. Moving on to the convention center in Tulsa later that night.
Yeah, Val's had about 25 shots there to the head.
D'Lo is doing something with a turnbuckle pad. Well, he's removing it. That's what he's doing. And Val right into that exposed bolt. That may be enough.
Yeah!
And D'Lo Brown took a shortcut. But it did work. And he has defeated Val
Here's
Venus.
Your winner, the World Wrestling Federation European Champion, D'Lo Brown.
Exactly right, Jack. D'Lo's taunting Val. Yeah, that's it. I'd be taunting him too.
I think that's Val's first loss, isn't it?
I do not know. Win-loss record of Val Venus. But Val's not too happy about it. Oh, he's taking that chest protector off.
Val Venus is exposing D'Lo Brown. And now Val wants some retribution.
Oh, powerbomb!
Oh, Val is putting on D'Lo's chest protector. Don't tell me that Val is going to be... He's looking for that money shot with D'Lo's own chest protector.
Halfway across the ring.
Yeah! Yeah!
How your ribs feel, D'Lo?
D'Lo Brown is hurting for certain. Mr. McMahon is what? Mr. McMahon is on his way out here to reveal the master plan.
Come on out, pup. Master plan time.
Well, many of you must be wondering, why is Vince McMahon wearing black?
Oh, you look great in black, though, Pop.
Actually, I'm wearing black because I'm in mourning. Yes, Vince McMahon is in mourning. I'm in... What's that? Oh. You too will be in mourning soon enough.
Crowd chanting for Stone Cold Steve Austin.
I'm in mourning because on September 27, Stone Cold Steve Austin's reign as the WWF champion will die.
Yeah. How does he know that? We heard that last night as well.
And in a moment, I will be further addressing Stone Cold Steve Austin. But right now, Undertaker.
What are they saying?
Hey. No, it's very, very disrespectful.
Undertaker, I understand you and Kane are looking for me. I'm obviously not too hard to find.
Yeah, you tell him, Pop.
Mr. McMahon is a sitting duck, for the lack of a better term, if he thinks he's going to turn back the challenge of Kane and The Undertaker here.
What do you mean, sitting duck? Mr. McMahon, my Pop can handle himself. After you go on national television and call two monsters pussies twice, something's up, and The Undertaker and Kane mean business. This is not going to be a social visit. And Mr. McMahon is going to create some distance between himself and those two demons. And who can blame him for that?
All I'm asking you. Just wait.
Oh, God! Oof. Damn!
I know you can destroy me within the blink of an eye. I'm just asking you for one thing. I want to apologize. I want to publicly and humbly apologize for my remarks to you, Undertaker, and to you, Kane. There's no question now in anyone's mind, you are the single most destructive force in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. And I apologize for my remarks, and I mean it from the bottom of my heart.
See that sincerity, JR? That's sincerity.
Undertaker, I truly believe that you deserve another opportunity to be the WWF champion. I do. I believe, Undertaker, you deserve a rematch. And Kane, you're equally destructive, Kane. Kane, you deserve an opportunity to once again wear the World Wrestling Federation Championship. And the only thing right now missing with this equation is the current WWF champion. And Stone Cold Steve Austin, if you have the guts to come out here and stand before Vince McMahon, come on down.
Well, what is the damn master plan?
Well, I think we're just about to find out here. That's what it's all about. Vince's master plan.
All the combustible elements are before you as we speak here on Sunday Night Heat. You can feel the animosity. You can feel the tension. Your dad's expression changed.
Austin, for the life of me, I have no idea what these fans see in you. I haven't a clue. I have no idea why they stand behind you. The fact of the matter is that you've disrespected Vince McMahon for the very last time.
You tell him, Pop, yeah.
Let me tell you something. You've mocked my authority for the very last time, Pally.
Yeah, Pally!
There's no, absolutely no redeeming social or otherwise any value whatsoever that you bring to the World Wrestling Federation. Not one. And that's why, Austin, on Sunday, September 27th, you're going to defend the World Wrestling Federation Championship. You're going to defend the championship against Kane.
Wow, Kane beat Austin, the King of the Ring, for the title.
And let me tell you something else, Austin. On September 27, you're going to defend the WWF Championship against The Undertaker.
What?
This is getting good.
Two matches?
Let me break it down for you, Austin. Okay, it's real simple. On Sunday night, September 27, Austin, you're going to defend the WWF Championship against both The Undertaker and Kane in a triple threat match.
Well, that's not fair.
A win is not fair. A win. Brilliant plan. Brilliant master plan.
Austin is doomed. Austin can't survive that against these two monsters.